sometimes it's necessary to pass values to a function. Let me show you what I mean. We're going to create a new program, and I'll call it pass values, and I'll click OK. All right, in this program, I'm going to start by doing the using namespace at the top. Let's create a function that will calculate the average of three numbers. So it's going to return the average, so I'll call it double average, and it's going to take in three double values, double A, double B, and double C. In the function, we'll return the value of adding A plus B plus C. So I'm just going to say return A plus B plus C. Sorry, and I want to divide that by 3 so that it will calculate the average of any three numbers that the main function passes to it. All right, in the main function, let's create three more variables. Let's create double x and set x equal to 5. And then we'll have y. Y can be equal to 10. And then we'll have z and set z equal to 15. All right, so we want to calculate the average of those three numbers and then print it out. So let's create double AVG equals a call to the average function, and we're going to give the average function x, y, and z. Now, what's going to happen is the values 5, 10, and 15 will be substituted in for x, y, and z. Then when we get to line 5, A will have the value of x, which will be 5, B will have the value of y, which will be 10, C will have the value of Z, which will be 15. And when you add those together and divide by 3, you get the value 10. So let's print it out. Now let's run the program. And we get the average is 10. So it's not real hard to understand the process of sending values from one function to another. Remember, the list of values inside the function is called the formal parameters. In this case, we have double A, double B, and double C. Now, what I want to show you also is that I can change A, B, and C inside the method average, and it will not change X, Y, and Z in the main function. So let's just say we're going to do A plus equals 3, and let's do B plus equals 4, and let's do C plus equals 5. Now this is going to change the value that gets returned from the average, but it's not going to change the values of x, y, and z. So down here, I'm going to just print out the values of x, y, and z so we can see them. So I'll say x, and I'll do the same thing for y and z. So I'm going to copy and paste this 2 more times. And let's make this one y, and this one z. It would also be nice to be able to see the values of a, b, and c as well. So let's copy these 3 cout statements and let's paste them up here. And let's change the values to be A, B, and C. Now let's run the program and see what we get. This time we see A is 8, B is 14, and C is 20, which is because in the function we actually added values. So the average of those three is 14. But look at x, y, and z. They're still 5, 10, and 15, respectively. And again, that's because x, y, and z are declared locally inside the main, and a, b, and c are declared locally inside the function. All right? Now, the next thing I want to do is I want to actually show you how we can pass these values instead of pass by value. In pass by value, it makes a copy of the value, and then A has its own value going forward. But there is a way to actually say pass by reference. What we can do is we can change these variables up here. So I can change A, and I can say double ampersand, and B, I can say double ampersand. Remember, the ampersand is the address of variable. So what's going to happen is it's actually going to have the address of X, Y, and Z now in our A, B, and C variables. Let me just add an end L here so it's a little easier to read. And I'll do the same thing down here. All right, this time what's going to happen is the three values, 5, 10, and 15, are going to be passed A, B, and C. But when I change A, B, and C in my function called average, it's actually changing the value that's pointed to by the address of A, which is the same address of X. So you'll actually see X, Y, and Z will be changed when we're done. So let's run it again. This time, when I ran it, A is still 8, B is still 14, and C is 20, and the average is still 14. But look what X, Y, and Z this time. When I do pass by reference, it actually passes a pointer to where that value is in memory. So when I change it in the function from 5 to 8, and from 10 to 14, and from 15 to 20, it changes it in the main method as well, or the main function as well. So when we're passing values to a function, we can either pass by value, which means you make a copy of it, or pass by reference. When I pass by reference, that means that I'm passing the address of the variable, in this case, the value 5, 10, and 15 respectively, to the average function, which is changing those values. So when I come back from the calling function, back from main, those values are changed as well.